Welcome back to Mechanics of Machinery. So we were dealing with how to draw the cam profile of a knife edge follower. We have already seen how to draw it when the line of stroke is passing through the follower passes through the camshaft axis. Now we will see how it can be done for an offset cam. That means cam will be offset by certain distance from the camshaft or axis of the camshaft. So here it is 12 mm. So data again I am mentioning, we have drawn the displacement diagram. Outstroke is 120, dwell is 30, return stroke is 120 again. And maximum lift is 20 mm. I have taken 20 mm as 4 cm. That means 1:2 I have taken. Sorry, 2:1 I have taken as the scale for drawing the lift. So it is better to take the same lift for drawing the cam profile also. So you can just sketch these blue lines onto the cam profile directly with the compass. So now how to do it with the offset? So again I am taking the same scale, that is 1 mm is equal to 2 mm. So our cam radius is 25 mm. So when I take that scale as 1 mm equal to 2 mm, we can use a cam profile that equates to 5 mm radius. So let's taking a 5 mm radius. Let's try to do a 5 mm radius. So that will be this center. You can just draw a circle of 5 mm radius with a compass, no problem, because of the unavailability of compass in the Now you have seen line of stroke of the follower is offset by 12 mm. Here the line of stroke of the follower was passing through the center of the cam. Now it is offset by 12 mm. So whatever be the 12 offset, you have to draw another circle with the radius of that. So since here it is 12 mm offset, you have to draw a circle of 12 mm. And according to this scale, that 12 mm will be 4 mm. Sorry, 24 mm. So just let's mark that 24 mm on this diagram to draw that circle. Since it is offset by 12 mm, we have to draw it a circle, offset circle of that same radius according to our scale. Because my scale is double, I am drawing it to 2.4 mm. Somewhere around here. So this will be the offset circle. And we can mark it as 12 mm offset, even though I have taken a 24 mm according to this scale. This scale should be matched with the scale you took for the maximum lift, otherwise it will be difficult to scale it back this displacement diagram values of these blue lines. Okay, now you have to pass a horizontal line through the circle to get that point. And now you have your cam axis and the follower line of stroke is 12 mm offset. So follower line of stroke will be vertical line passing through the tangent with the diameter. So that will be vertical line passing through this one. So that will be the axis of the follower. So let's mark the axis. And again, you can draw a knife edge follower very roughly. That will be a knife edge follower. Now you have an outstroke of 120 mm, but that should not be taken from this vertical line because our axis is shifted. What you have to do is you have to draw a line connecting the point where the follower touches the cam base circle and the center of the base circle. And from here onwards you have to take that 120, 30 and all those things. So now taking a protractor, marking the angles now. So 120 is the outstroke. So this will be outstroke length, 30 degree dwell. Then let's mark that first. You don't have to extend it this time. Just keep it just by touching the circle, because that will not be, line will not be extended for drawing. We will see how it is. Now the return stroke, that is another 120. So another 120. And if you measure it correctly and accurately, you will get the last line as 90 degree correctly. Even though my measurements are off a little bit, still I will get a very value close to 90. You see? Yeah, that will be the line. Let's adjust it. So that will be passing through here, 90 degree. So again, this will be the outstroke 120. This will be the dwell 30. This will be the return stroke 120. And that will be the last dwell 90. Now, we have to divide this line as we did for the non-offset. That is same divisions as the number that we divided the displacement diagram of. So, 6 divisions, 120 degree, 20 degree divisions. You can use either a protractor or use the first 20 degree and cut the circumference with the same length with the compass. So, 20, first 20, second. Six. Okay, that will be the lines that we require. Now we can just draw the lines to cut the circumference of the circle. You don't have to extend it this time because we will not be drawing it from this point. We just want these points to cut the circumference of the circle from the center. Because we are doing it in an offset method. In an offset method, we are not going to draw it on these lines. We are going to draw it from the tangents. We will see how it is done now. That line will come as perpendicular actually. Let me erase that line. Don't require that line. If you draw it correctly, it will come as perpendicular. I have just drawn it a little off. That's why. Okay. So 20, 60 degree divisions. So now you have to name it accordingly that we have done the displacement diagram 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, then 0 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, last one 6 dash. Now, in offset cam profile diagram, what you have to do is, you have to draw the tangents from this 1, 2, 3, 4 to the offset diagram, offset circle. So, it should be a perfect tangent from 2 to again, tangent, you know what is a tangent. So, draw the tangent from each of these points to the offset circle. Tangent means just touching the circumference of the circle or making a 90 degree radius with these lines. Actually, you can draw a tangent by putting a 90 degree with each of the circumference lines, the division lines that you have cut. That will be the radius vector. So, that will be that. And you have to draw it from there, then again starting from here, tangents, each of these should be a perfect tangents, yeah, and then you have to extend these tangents to draw the actual cam profile. So just extending those tangents, or you can extend this when extend it already when you draw it. So just extending the tangents. It is with this tangents that we actually draw the cam profile with, not the actual division lines, but the tangent lines, because it is an offset method. This is the methodology to draw the offset method. So we have to draw the tangents from the division lines of the outstroke and return stroke to the offset circle. Oh, we forgot to draw a tangent from here. We have to draw a tangent from the 0 dash also. my drawings may be a little off, but you can draw it carefully and accurately with a pen and pencil. There are limitations to show it online. Yeah, so that will be the lines. Now again, simple method, you have to mark this B point on to this one point by measuring it from here with a compass. Put your compass in one and cut an arc at B, and put the compass again at one and cut the same distance at B. Similarly, cut at C from 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You will get it. And similarly, you will get the cam profile according to the value. So if you have to measure each line with the ruler, you do it. Otherwise, the best easiest method is place your compass pointer at 2, cut an arc at C, keep that distance, place your compass at 2, cut an arc at C. So you'll get a C. A will be here. B, C, D, E, F, G, then H, I, J, H, K, L, M, N. If you do it correctly, you will get a slightly better diagram, because I am not using a compass, so I am just predicting it. You can use a compass to cut it correctly and you will get a cam profile. So just now you have to just pass through the lines with the smooth curve freehandly. So connect A to B like this. Again, I have not measured actually the points, so it may be a little off my diagram, but you will get a correct diagram. So this will be the offset cam profile. Last dwell also you mark. Even if you don't mark the last dwell, it's okay. So this is the offset cam profile. So first, again, you have to draw the base circle, then you have to draw the offset circle, both according to the scale. That scale should be same as the lift you have drawn for displacement diagram. Then you have to divide the outstroke into same number of parts you have divided the displacement diagram, return stroke also. Then you have to mark the division lines on the circumference of the circle, and from these points you have to draw a tangent to the offset circle. Then you have to extend the tangents and determine these points B, C, D, E, F according to the measurements you get from the displacement diagram, these blue lines. Then you have to draw it and you will get a cam profile. This is how you draw it for a offset method. Hope you have understood both offset method as well as same line of stroke method for both knife edge followers. And when it comes to flat followers or flat surface followers, it is a little slightly different, but the same procedure happens. Thank you.